Called Wiggle.
Gonna try out some stuff. I'm not, but Azyxa is. His friend Shawn's taking us to this place called the Strip.
Anything for you?
No, thank you.
Love Potion Spring Garden.
What'd you get?
The Spring Garden.
Green Garden?
Spring Garden. Has gin, elderflower, and orange bitters.
Yum.
Sean got the love potion.
Love potion, number 9?
No. No number.
Get a little food. There's a banh mi place right here.
That is really good. We got some banh mi from this famous lady, apparently. And then right next to it, they have like an actual fire pit pizza place. It's incredible. It's crazy. It's insane. Like actual fire pit. We're like back here eating, and it's really good. I already tried it. There's a shopping cart there for some reason. How is it?
It's really good.
Yeah, super tasty.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I do.
Yes.
It's really good.
Stop.
We're at a place called Manami, and Dix just got 100% chocolate, Francois Prelude. So disgusting.
So good.
So good. Oh, they even give you an ice pack.
Yeah.
To keep it cool.
Yeah.
That is so pro. Wow.
So pro.
Wow. And I got a stracciatella gelato.
That's good.
Chocolate foot.
That's tasty. That's tasty. Yeah, and then foot. And I bought these cool glasses there.
Oh, yeah.
Because they are pro. They're so awesome. No, no way.
She's going to wear them with salt.
Yeah. I'm going to wear those with salt. We're stopped at a spice shop. I forget what it's called.
Penzies.
Ready when you guys are?
Let me get back there.
And
we're going to five, right?
Peppercorn is
I never heard back,
so. The worst thing you can put on steak. What was I thinking of? A hamburger. Yeah. Not good. Also, I just found out what a shins is. The word again? Yins.
Yins.
Yes. Figure out what a yins is and what mat means. Shins is an abbreviation for. Forgot now. What's shins an abbreviation for?
No, yins.
Yins.
You all.
Like y'all or you yins guys, and then there's nat, which is yins and bad.
Coming over.
So, see, I'm being culturally integrated in Pittsburgh. No, so, I don't know where we're headed, but we're going to keep going. It's pretty busy. Poor guy is missing a claw. We're at a We're at a fish market called Holy Fish.
Holy Fish.
And there are like fish, fresh fish everywhere. And like, it's crazy. So much fish, free samples of I don't know, something.
It might be too much food right now.
No, oh my gosh. Wow, that is what you call a sample.
Someone come in like a minute.
Oh, crabs. Look at crabs. Okay. We're gonna go back out now. And leave the fish. Goodbye, fish. Picked up two CDs, like literally CDs. I got two CDs. I got the old school dance party number five and number three, because it's good. It's some good stuff. I'll show you like what's on the playlist. I like it. It's good stuff. Called Maggie's Farm, and they're gonna try some more, I think some rum, so like a rum bar or something like that. Yeah. They have a really cool door. The door is awesome. I like it. Very neat. It's really nice to paint. What's hardcore?
No, I do.
Is it good?
Oh my God.
Yes. See the atmosphere with like certain chemicals to it. Yeah.
The atmosphere.
Look, Jemima says chemtrails. We have now stopped at a coffee shop called Ludo or Commonplace. And what area is this?
Garfield.
Garfield. And there's an awesome green wall behind me that I love. That is like the perfect green right there. And we're supposed to go eat dinner in like, literally like I think 20 minutes. And the barista gave us free dessert.
Free awesomeness in a jar.
Oh my gosh.
It's like, what's in here? Cake, whiskey, stout.
Coffee,
and I don't even
chocolate, like coffee flavored.
And some kind of like buttercream.
It's all mixed so well, it's so good.
Yeah, it's insane.
So I mean, my appetite is just...
They were free. And Shawn Wall like knows everyone that
likes it. It's free. It's free, so you couldn't turn it down, and it tastes so good, so you can eat it.
That's what I even said here. You got awesomeness in a jar.
Oh, man.
And we got cold brew coffee.
Cold brew coffee. Yeah.
We were drinking rum from the barrel.
We were drinking rum from the barrel earlier. It's been like amazeballs.
Day of gluttony.
Day of debauchery.
Day of debauchery. And then we got to go to Salt of the Earth, which is your favorite restaurant.
Yeah.
In the world.
Well, in Pittsburgh.
In Pittsburgh.
Frank gave us secret cardboard pieces. We had to pick. He was authorized. Let's read the whole thing.
We're now at Salt of the Earth, which is the restaurant, and we're gonna have some dinner. Strawberry jalapeno
cucumber with mint in it.
So good. Food has arrived. We got the hanger steak. We're gonna split it. It's got kimchi and sesame rice. See how it tastes?
Yeah.
Try a piece. First person like perspective of eating. Oh wow. It's really good. And Eric's been telling me about his love of white.
Love of white.
Magic. Okay, we're back home and our sister's house. And I'm just going to do a little haul of what we've gotten so far. I didn't really buy much here, but I figured I'd share what I've gotten so far, and it's mostly alcohol, which is so weird, because I don't normally, most of the stuff isn't for me. There's only one thing I got for myself. This is for Flip and Azyxa. They'll probably split this later on. This is the Dogfish Head 120-minute IPA, the Imperial India Ale. Got it, the D something, I can't remember. And it is seriously like intense. Apparently this can wipe you out. So super, super strong alcohol content. This is a little distillery we went to today in on the strip. It's called Wiggle and it's a rye whiskey. You got the small cask series. And then when we went to the bar the other day called the Brew Gentleman Company, he got this wheat stout. This is all stuff I would not drink. But today we went to a rum distillery and called Maggie's Farms. And this is a spiced rum. And I didn't think I would like spiced rum that much. But this is probably the best rum I've ever had in my entire life. It is so good. Like everything he was making with this just tasted amazing, like so amazing. So I can't wait to try, and I'm gonna make an eggnog with this because it tastes like Christmas. It's like Christmas in a bottle. Like it is so, so good. And then I picked up, we were on the street, the vendor was selling CDs, like, you know, like fucking ripped CDs, like look at that, with like Sharpie markers on them. But they were playing these like kind of old school jams, and this has like, you know, it has Aretha Franklin, Jump to It, SOS Band, Just Be Good to Me, Black Street, No Diggity, Digital Underground, same song, and Earth, Wind, and Fire, Let's Groove, Freddie Jackson, Jam Tonight. It's called Old School Dance Party Number 5, but they were doing like 2 for $5, so we got a second one, and this one has stuff like Belle Biv DeVoe, Poison. That's not actually one of my favorite songs, but like LTD, Back in Love Again, Soul for Real, Candy Rain, Craig Mack, Flavor in Your Ear. I mean, just like, and these are really like really good mixes. I don't know, they're really like awesome when they were playing them on the side of the street. So picked it up, and we don't have an MP3 player or one of those audio auxiliary cables in our car, so we have to listen to CDs. So I was like, hell yeah, this is, I'll get that. And then his sister was going to give this to Goodwill. It's the little cat from Trigon. And so it's a little backpack thingy, and I was like, you know what, I need this, like, cause, like, she just, I was like, cause the first thing I saw it on the counter, I was like, oh, that's so cute, and she's like, I'm gonna give it to Goodwill. I was like, she's like, you want it? I was like, heck yeah, I'll take it, that's so cute. And I was just like, carry it around, I was like, I've always, cause I've been wanting a little backpack purse, for a while, so when I go, don't, it can be hands-free, cause my shoulder's been hurting with this freaking bag I've been carrying around everywhere. And then last, but not least, the first day we got in, we stopped at the grocery store so that we could pick up, you know, some Cokes for me, or, you know, Coke Zeros and some Gatorade and just things that I could have so I can, stuff to drink. And I saw this. It is Reese's Peanut Butter Cup flavored Oreos, limited edition. Reese's Peanut Butter Cup and Oreo together. This could possibly be the greatest combination ever. Like, ever. We haven't tried it yet. I think we're just going to save it until we get back. And then, because we don't want to go stale. Daisy's coming to visit. Come here, baby. She's so excited we're home again. You left me. You left me when you went to downtown Pittsburgh. Yeah. So much debauchery you missed out on. Yeah. Oh, and then I got, of course, these awesome glasses, which, as soon as I saw them, I was like, I must have these, because they are so nerdy and awesome. Just like, yeah, yeah. So, yeah, that's about it. I've been having a really good time. I'm super, super tired. Azyxa went over to his friend's house. We were supposed to go hang out over there. And apparently has this really cool place that has, like, stained glass windows, his house, and a big, like, fireplace in the middle of the living room, and I told him to go try to get footage. So if he actually did it, I'll insert it now, and if not, then pretend that I didn't say that, and I'll just keep continuing.
This is terrible chilling.
Ripley's freaking out.
Ripley
already headbutted Shawn in the nuts.
Yeah, she's like swung with two fists. Like,
we got magic on the TV. Watching a tournament. Where's Eric? Chill, Ripley. Stained glass window. Magic table. And now the Zobars come online. That's what you do. Here's attack four. Little clean fire for you. Those nice windows.
Oh, yeah.
To the outside. I'm gonna eat camera. Mr. Burton. Hello, Mr. Burton. Do what?
Have some cigars.
Have some cigars. In the jungle. Man. Crazy.
Yeah, I gotta cut some of these trees back. That's part of the reason I got that ladder.
Yeah, you don't want them, like, hitting the house. Then
the bugs come in. And...
Yep. We actually have trees hitting the house right now. Branches, and they're, like, destroying the shingles that overhang.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's really annoying. Slime! That is sweet.
Yeah, that sounds pretty fun. Yeah.
Does this still work?
Yeah.
Run all the MAME stuff?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, you can...
So, yeah, so awesome. Yeah, I remember seeing it, like, in here, but the room wasn't done really yet.
No.
Jack Burton.
Oh, Kurt Russell's trying everything. Having the thing and grindhouse. Death proof. I just need the Jack Burton centerpiece. I don't have that.
That's awesome.
But I have the original knife from the original. Not from the movie, but this is a
nice.
Nice knife, Mr. Burton.
It's on the reflexes.
This is awesome.
Low pan. I remember he was at he was down in a convention in Austin that we were in.
Oh really?
Yeah, I saw him, but I didn't get anything like, you know.
So yeah, I've been really enjoying my time here, just having a lot of fun. Like we did sightseeing today, hung out yesterday, and tomorrow we're going to AnthroCon. I'm so excited. It's the furry convention, the biggest furry convention in the United States, and I am so excited, and I just love furries. I don't know why. I just love furries, and I'm just gonna, like, I don't know what's considered kosher at a furry con, but I just want to go up to everyone and, like, hug them and hold them and just be like, oh, I love furries. I don't know why I like furries. I have no idea what I like about them. For me, it's not a kink thing. It's not even a freak thing. It's just, I just really enjoy, like, the art of furriness. Like, I love people dressed up as big, giant, stuffed animals or bears or animal spirits or whatever. Because they're just, like, you know, plush and... I don't know. I just really dig it. So I'm so excited we get to go tomorrow. We're going to check it out with two of his other friends we haven't met yet. And yeah, we'll see what that's like. I'm so excited. It just happened to land on the weekend, like, that we were coming up here, that FurryCon was going to happen. I was just like, well, AnthroCon is what it's called. But I'm so excited. So I'll be getting footage of that, which should be interesting. Because I don't know what to expect. I've never been to a furry convention. I don't even know how people react to other people who aren't dressed up at a furry convention. So, I don't know. It'll be a new experience. And, yeah. So, I think that's about everything. And I'm going to go get ready for bed. Oh, yeah. I forgot. I got this shirt, too. His sister... it smells so good. We used his sister's washer and dryer today. And I got to wash this. And so I'm wearing my skull sweater that I got from H&M the other day. And it's really comfortable. I really like it a lot. And it's super light for a summer sweater. And yeah, okay, so I think that's everything. I think I'll hold everything now. If I missed anything, I'll add it in later. And yeah, so and then I'm going to start editing videos that I have here. Laptop or whatever, and yeah, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Say bye, Daisy. Bye, bye, guys. Furries.